Hello, my friends, and welcome back to the rabbit hole. In today's video, we are talking all about vitamin C in skincare. Does it last in your products? Do you need to worry about your vitamin C products going bad? Indeed, today's video is going to be all about specifically LAA, L-ascorbic acid, and it's probably going to be one of my nerdier videos, just so you know, but I will try to condense this information and make it something where you really get a good take-home point, and I certainly think there is one in today's video. So let me start off today's video by telling you a little bit about the problems with L-ascorbic and why a lot of skincare companies have started turning to the vitamin C derivatives in place of this ingredient. So, L-ascorbic acid is notoriously unstable. It's an ingredient that has to be formulated at a lower pH, which can be a little bit more difficult to use if you have a more sensitive skin type. It also is an ingredient that is prone to oxidizing, and so because of that, you see a lot of companies kind of try to figure out ways to stabilize that ingredient with vitamin E or ferulic acid, that of course being patented by SkinCeuticals, and other companies do have different ways that they attempt to do this. You also often see vitamin C products packaged in opaque packaging. This right here being two examples of how your L-ascorbic might be packaged in a completely opaque bottle like this, where it is not exposed to air and it is just a pump, or at the very least in a brown bottle. The problem is I've seen a lot of additional concerns beyond just the company manufacturing these products. I've seen people express concern around, you know, is it safe to order a vitamin C by mail? Is it going to go bad on you in transit? What is the best way to store a vitamin C product once you have it? Do you have to throw it away after a few weeks? And what about these companies that are selling L-ascorbic in clear glass bottles? Is that okay? As an inquisitive mind, I wanted these kinds of answers, so I thought, let's do a very science fair-esque project and take some of my L-ascorbic serum and expose it to different variables. And that is indeed what today's video is going to cover, is what happened, because it actually turns out to be very interesting and actually not what I expected thoroughly. It kind of is and kind of isn't. So let's go ahead and talk about the project that I did. By the way, young people watching this video, if you want your parents to buy you skincare, just make it a science fair project. I'm so full of good ideas. So let's talk about what I did and what happened. Hopefully I'm scooted over enough so I can put everything up on the screen and show you. Basically what I did is I took the Rosin Bright Citrus Serum, which is an L-ascorbic serum that is much more affordable, especially since I'm, you know, wasting products, even if in the name of greater good. I've talked about this serum before and how I think it is stabilized in a brilliant way, using natural products as stabilizers in place of what SkinCeuticals does to make a product that can be affordable without having to pay L'Oreal for the patent. You know what I'm saying? I'd already had some interesting experiences with this serum in the past. It comes out such a light color. It's almost clear, just a little tiny bit of yellow to it, but over time I'd collected some on the edges of the bottle and that was turning quite brown, which you expect from oxidized vitamin C. So I thought this would be a perfect candidate for this little experiment over here. So let me show you what I did. So I took some of this serum and I pumped it out into three little glass vials and also a brown bottle. And with the three little vials, I put one in the window, so it was ideally exposed to a lot of UV light, which in theory would help to speed up the oxidation process. I also put one in the refrigerator, which would ideally slow down oxidation, as cold temperatures slow down any kind of reactions, kind of like how if you're cold, you know how you don't want to do anything? It's the same logic for any kind of reaction. And then I also put one on the bathroom counter, which is where I assume most people tend to store their skincare. So I came back to everything 1 week later, and I was really surprised by what was already happening. So the control, I pumped the control into a fourth vial, and you can see there's not really a difference between the control and the clear bottle that was kept in the refrigerator. But when you look at the bathroom counter in the window, it's almost like the bathroom counter is a little more yellow than the window, which is not what you expect, right? Since there hadn't been a lot of change in that first week, I thought it would be interesting to take that fourth vial and add in another variable, and that is to have one of these completely open and exposed to air. So I took the lid off of my new control and I exposed it to air in the bathroom, just had it sitting out, no lid. I expected this to very rapidly oxidize because think about that word oxidize, exposure to oxygen. And sure enough, 1 week later, we had some very interesting situations going on here. So you're now looking at 2 weeks and you can see that the refrigerator still hasn't really changed. In spite of being in that clear packaging, it still looks pretty good. But the window and the counter are both definitely starting to get a little orange, and the one with no lid has caught up to them. That is 1 week without a lid compared to 2 weeks in the window and the counter. So you can see how that really was speeding up the reaction. Let's see what happened in 3 weeks. 3 weeks is where we're really starting to see that orange color, that sign of oxidation in both the window and the product that was left on the counter. Meanwhile, the product that was in the fridge still looks really good. It looks like we still have primarily L-ascorbic in there and not as much converted products. However, the no lid condition, oh my goodness. Now I know ideally nobody is storing their skincare with no lid on it, but this one was so interesting to me. This one not only was really turning quite brown, showing that we might have a Maillard reaction actually happening here, but we also had some amount of what looked like salt in the bottle. Oh my goodness, this is so interesting because it is possible for L-ascorbic acid to convert into the salt form, into the ascorbate form, and I think we did it. I think we managed to make that reaction happen just by taking the lid off. So we're caught up to the present. We are at 4 weeks of this trial. I did go ahead and cap this one, the no lid condition, because I kind of just wanted to see if it would stop the reaction, and it kind of seemed to. It did seem that once I put the lid on, it was no longer as actively converting into the ascorbate form and oxidizing. The refrigerator still looks great. That's still definitely the pale yellow color that you would expect L-ascorbic to be. So the refrigerator seemed to really be a good option, even in a clear bottle. And I think this makes a lot of sense because if you think about it, your refrigerator isn't exposed to light all day. As long as you keep the door closed, which you of course do, then the product is still not exposed to light. So in reality, this just got minimally exposed to light. But the bathroom and the window conditions did not go as I expected. I expected the window to be much more oxidized, and yet what we actually see is the product that was in the bathroom is more oxidized. So we kind of have to stop here and say, okay, so what does that mean? At first I was so surprised about this, but then I got to thinking about it, and there is something that is going on specifically at this time of the year, and that is it's a little bit colder outside. So I think what was happening is that for the product that was exposed to the window, it was exposed to UV light, but the temperature helped to slow down the reactions, which ultimately means the bathroom counter is kind of one of the worst places to keep your L-ascorbic products. Uh-oh, is she about to sell you a skincare fridge? No, I don't necessarily think you need to buy a separate skincare fridge. I do happen to have one now because I got it for $30, and that was pretty hard to resist. But in all reality, if you cannot afford a skincare fridge right now, just keep your products in your regular refrigerator, which most likely, if you are also on a budget like me, it's probably not that far of a walk to your fridge, is it? I counted. It was 10 steps to my refrigerator in the kitchen. Yeah, the skincare fridge was probably optional for me. It probably was. But we do have one more thing to do for this video. I don't have any extra vials, so we do have to pump out some of the control as well as the brown bottle. Let's see how the brown bottle fared next to the opaque bottle. This is a real moment of truth, so I figured we would go ahead and film it. All right, let's take from the brown bottle and see how that is looking in comparison to the completely clear bottle. Wow, that is surprising to me. We actually have a fair amount of oxidation in
the brown bottle. It looks like it did do better than the regular bathroom counter, but actually not by that much. I am surprised by that. All right, let's see our original control. I am in awe. Our completely opaque bottle does look crystal clear. Let's switch these two around here. So we have our original control right here, the product that was kept in the fridge in the completely opaque bottle. Look at that. Look at how clear that product is. The one that was kept in a clear bottle in the refrigerator, we did not see any, I would not say that's really oxidized. We might have some conversion to dehydroacetic acid, but that should still be fine to use. That actually goes both forward and backward in reaction. It can redox back into L-ascorbic. And then over here, we have the opaque bottle that was left on the counter, and then we have the clear bottle. I'm actually really amazed by that.
So let's wrap up this video with some final conclusions, some final thoughts. What is the best way to store your L-ascorbic products? You know, I think it's so interesting that this did not go exactly how I thought it would. While the product without a lid, which probably nobody is going to store their skincare in that way, while that did oxidize like I expected it to, it went above and beyond with converting into the salt form. The window versus the bathroom counter is still absolutely shocking to me and really goes to show, do not store your L-ascorbic serums in the bathroom. Not in clear packaging and not in brown packaging either. And don't forget another element of this. I was not opening these bottles on a day-to-day basis. With a product like this where you have a dropper, you are opening that daily. So I do think this is a lot more prone to oxidizing than maybe we've realized in the past. Yeah, I don't think I'd buy a vitamin C like this anymore, even though I have in the past. This was an L-ascorbic bottle. Meanwhile, the control, the product that was kept in this packaging, which is not exposed to air and is not exposed to light and was kept in the refrigerator, it's as good as new. And you know, I've actually had this for a couple months now. So to summarize everything, I would definitely recommend buying your vitamin C in packaging like this. If you do end up getting a vitamin C that is in different packaging, at least keep it in your refrigerator, because as we saw, clear packaging in the refrigerator still did pretty well. It still did pretty well. And that is all I have for today's video. Let me know your thoughts. Leave me a comment in the comment section below. And if you did find this video helpful, please make sure to hit the like button and subscribe. And I will see you guys next time.